Our company's objective is to provide the tools that allow educators to improve competency for the next generation of healthcare providers, doctors, nurses, first responders, and those in the military. Technology has really allowed us to do that. When you look at our simulators today, they are high fidelity, very sophisticated robots that can be controlled by the Surface Pro anywhere at any time.
We've had clients in remote parts of the world do simulations in the mountains where they actually take a full body patient simulator and they do a search and rescue in the jungle, bringing a simulator down to an area where they can go ahead and airlift them and then take them to a hospital. And Surface Pro has allowed them to do the entire scenario from start to finish without interruption. When Surface was introduced, it really changed the game because it was much lighter than every other PC out there. The battery life was stellar, and it really provides clients something that was dual purpose. They can use it as a laptop, they can control it with one hand.
All of our students are graduate level students, so they use a lot of simulators. When it comes to birthing mannequins and our pediatric mannequins, those are the best for that field. So we're the ones that are back there on the computer manipulating the mannequin, changing the vital signs, making them have a seizure, but we're watching, and so we're just changing it based on the student's performance.
As technology continues to advance, we incorporate that technology into this education. So that's where HoloLens comes in. Our robot, the size of an adult woman, can deliver a baby. And when the baby's born, is crying or cyanotic, and the students can look inside that patient and see how the baby's moving.
We hear a lot of clients say, I wish I had this when I was in medical school, or I wish I had this when I was in nursing school, and they can really see the value. When COVID hit, there was a huge need for providers to operate mechanical ventilators. And there was a need for a lot of them, more than were available. So simulation actually was used to retrain healthcare providers from one area to the other so they can assess with the needs of the hospital at that particular point.
We want them to practice in this safe environment on this mannequin so that they can perfect it before they ever do it on a real person. So I can go through a whole nursing program and never take care of a patient that had a heart attack or never take care of a patient who had a stroke. But in simulation, I can guarantee that each student is going to have the opportunity to take care of a simulated patient. But that's the clear advantage of simulation, is safety.